at Johannesburg. They might have it. So when I went to Johannesburg, I go to the Bible house in Johannesburg. And I go and search for this Indonesian Bible. And I got it. And I'm looking in the shelves, some other books. I see a New Testament, Greek and English. Like we have the Quran, Arabic and English, Greek and English, the New Testament. I took that big volume out and I'm starting to go through that. And the supervisor of the Bible house is watching me. You know, with this funny headgear and this beard. He says, what this guy is doing with all these expensive volumes, because this was an expensive volume which I took down. Greek, English of the New Testament. So he comes up to me. He says, good morning. I said, good morning. He said, what makes you interested in these books? I said, no. I do comparative religion, and I have come across something here in this Greek English of the New Testament that can be of use to me. He found me an interesting character. He said, would you like to have a cup of tea with me? I said, no, I don't mind at all. So he took me into his office. I said, now, you know, we believe in Jesus. And this was something astonishing to this supervisor. And all the supervisors in South Africa of the Bible houses are retired reverends. This was a Reverend Dunkers, Reverend Dunkers. He's amazed. I says, you know, we believe in Jesus and in his miraculous birth. And so saying, I started repeating these verses from the Quran. That we believe. And when I read it, he said, no, this is the same like my book. What you are saying now, that when the good news is given to Mary, the mother of Jesus, in the Holy Quran, she says, قَالَتْ رَبِّيَنَّا يَكُنُوا لِي وَلَدٌ وَلَمْ يَمْسَسْنِي بَشَرٌ. She said, oh my Lord, how can I have a child when no man has touched me? Which means physically, sexually. No man has touched me. So the angel says, قَالَ كَذَلِكِ اللَّهُ يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاءُ. Even so, Allah creates what He wills. إِذَا قَدَى أَمْرًا فَإِنَّمَا يَقُولُ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونَ. Whenever he decrees a matter, he merely says to it, be, and he wills it and the thing comes into being. So the reverend says, man, this is the same as my book. I said, yes, on the face of it, it's the same. But if you look at it intently, you'll find the difference between my version and your version is chalk and cheese. You people know chalk and cheese? You know the difference between chalk and cheese? The Canadians didn't know. The Canadians, I'm telling you, when I went to Canada, I spoke about chalk and cheese, they didn't hear that phrase before. We, the English speaking people in South Africa, we know, everybody knows chalk and cheese. Chalk and cheese may look alike, white, white, but it says that's poles apart. You can't eat chalk, but you can eat cheese. No? But the Canadians didn't know. The Canadians didn't know. I'm telling you. I don't know whether you people know. Difference between chalk and cheese. The poles are, in other words, poles apart. So they said, how? I said, you know, in the Holy Bible, in the Gospel of St. Luke, we are told when this good news was given to Mary, the mother of Jesus, about the birth of the Holy Son, she says, how can this thing be when I know not a man? In the biblical language, know means sex. Know, know, to know means knowing sexually. Not she doesn't know a man. She knows her uncle, her fathers, her neighbors. Surely she knows other men. But no, no, no. Know in the biblical language means sex. When I have, in the Quran it says, no man has touched me. Again, it means not touched me, means had sex. Both the Quran and the Bible are saying the same thing. The replies to them are revealing. In the Holy Bible, the answer to Mary's protest was that the Holy Ghost will come upon thee. I'm reading the Bible to you. Look. The Holy Ghost will come upon thee, and the power of the Most High will overshadow thee. Now that gives you a mental picture. The Holy Ghost is a person. That's what the Christians say. The Father is a person, the Son is a person, and the Holy Ghost is a person, but they're not three persons, but one person. I don't know whether you heard that expression before. But he's a person. This Holy Ghost will come on Mary. How? She gives in your mind. Makes you think how? Like a man and a woman, like a bull and a cow. How? The Almighty will overshadow her. How? No, no, it gives you a mental picture. So I'm suggesting that it gives you a mental picture. You know, how the Holy Ghost will come on her. We know it's a miracle. We agree it's a miracle. But the language that you're using, The language is down to earth language. The Quran says, وَإِذَا قَدَى أَمْرًا فَإِنَّمَا يَكُولُ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونَ. For God to create Jesus without a human father, he says, kun, he says, be, and it is. For him, it's just to will it, and he comes into being. So, I'm asking the reverend. I said, now, between these two versions, we are both trying to say the same thing. We are both trying to give the same message, that he was born miraculously. There's no doubt about that. But, I said, which version would you prefer to give to your daughter? The Quranic version or the biblical version? We are both trying to say the same thing. He said, he bowed his head down in shame, and he said he would prefer to give the Quranic version. This is Reverend Dunkers, the head of the Bible Society in Johannesburg. You show this to your Christian friends and neighbors, your employers, your employees, and you see what happens. If they start being funny, then I'll show you other ways. Then it's the other method. But otherwise, this is how Allah expects us to talk to them, share with them. So the story is that in these verses, the story is that the mother of Mary, she was barren for a long period of time. And she prayed to God. So, oh my Lord, if you give me a child, I'll devote my child for temple services, for your service. I'll dedicate her. And God heard her prayer, and she became pregnant from her husband. And in time she delivered the child. And the child happened to be a female. And she was disappointed. She had vowed that that child she will dedicate, imagining, thinking it will be a son, a male. But it happened to be a female. What is she to do? She had vowed. So she buys her time when Mary was big enough that she can look after herself, her toiletries and all that. She takes this child to the temple for handing over. And the priest in the temple of Jerusalem, they're seeing this beautiful child. Everybody wants to be a godfather. You know godfather? That's how the Westerners say, you know, to look after the child as his own. Everyone says, look, I'll look after the child. The other one says, I'll be the godfather. I'll look after the child. And there's competition. So they started casting lots. Head or tail, head or tail. And it came to the turn of Zechariah. Zechariah won the toss. The father of John the Baptist, he won the toss. But in things like this, there's always a dispute. You say, you didn't play fair. You know, you didn't throw the dice nicely. You know, so there was a dispute. So the Quran says, the Quran tells us that, O Muhammad, you were not there when they cast lots with arrows as to which of them should be charged with the care of Mary, nor was thou with them when they disputed the point. How do you know these things? How does Muhammad know? He is an illiterate man, a man who doesn't know how to read or write. How does he know this? So Allah gives the answer. كَذَلِكَ مِنْ أَنْبَاءِ الْغَيْبِ نُوحِيهِ إِلَيْكَ. This is part of the tidings of the things unseen, which we reveal unto thee, O Messenger, by inspiration. This is how he got this knowledge. Whatever is given to him, he's got no choice, he's got to utter them. That Mary, a Jewess, the mother of Jesus, she is a woman chosen above the women of all nations. It doesn't make sense. When the Jews were looking down upon the Arabs for 3,000 years, do you know that? They said Father Abraham had two wives, Sarah and Hajra. Sarah and Hagar. We, the Jews, they say we are the children of Sarah. The first son through Abraham, Isaac. And from Isaac to Jacob, and Jacob to Judas, and Judas and his brethren, the 12 tribes of Israel, Jacob and all 12 tribes of Israel, and we are the Jews, the chosen people. Coming from this noble ancestry of Abraham through Isaac. Ishmael is the son of Hagar, Bibi Hajra. Ishmael is the first son, and through him the Arabs. They are cousins. Father Abraham is the father of the Jews as well as the Arabs. But the Jews have been looking down upon the Arabs for 3,000 years, that these Arabs are Hagarines. In the literature they call the Arabs Hagarines, means the children of Hagar, Bibi Hajra.